विद रिस्पेक्ट एंड विद रिस्पेक्ट टू विल दैट नोइंग. सो दिस आर्क ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट इज द पाथ ट्रेस्ड बाय पॉइंट ऑन पीच सर्कल. Point on a peach circle. So this G is the point on the peach circle. It is going to trace path along this peach circle up to this P. That is nothing but arc of approach from the start of engagement up to this peach point, and from this peach point P to the F point, which is on P circle of the wheel. That is nothing but arc of recess. So from the pitch point to the end of engagement. So this G, P and F, G, P and F. So like this, here it is P, here it is G, and here it is F. This is nothing but arc of contact, and the point G and F, so whatever distance covered, that is nothing but length of arc of contact. Okay. Now, how to find out this length of arc of contact? So for that, length of arc of approach. So again, this is G point. I will take a different color. This one is G point. This is P point. So this arc is nothing but length of path of length of arc of contact. So this, 1 minute, I will take pointer. So length of arc of approach, that is arc GP. GP, how to find out arc GP? Is equal to length of path of approach divided by cos phi. So this angle is called as a angle of approach, right? And whatever angle up to this F point, this is called as angle of recess. So length of arc of approach, this is the first part of this length of arc of contact. So this length of arc of approach, that is arc GP, is equal to length of path of approach, that is KP, divided by cos phi. Similarly, length of arc of recess, that is arc PF, from this P point to F point, what will be there? Length of path of recess divided by cos phi. So what is length of path of recess? That is PL and divided by cos phi as it is. So this will be asked in EMCQ. So this part will be asked in EMCQ type questions. What is length of arc of recess? These will be the options. Okay. Now, addition of these two, that is nothing but length of arc of contact, that is GPF, and is equal to this plus this. So finally we are going to get Kp plus Pl upon cos phi, right? So arc GP, arc PF, Kp upon this cos phi plus PL upon cos phi. Okay. And finally, GPF is equal to KL upon cos phi. So once we get value of this KL divided by cos phi, that will give length of arc of contact. So we can get the length of arc of contact with this equation. So length of arc of approach, length of arc of recess. So this first quantity, this one is the second one, and addition of these two will get length of arc of contact GPF. Okay. Next, you can write in your notebook contact ratio. Contact ratio. Contact ratio. Just write down title. Okay, completed. Now, whatever figure I have drawn on the slide, this indicate one pair. This is tooth number one and this is tooth number two. This is from wheel, this is from pinion. So what we are observing here, a pair. So one pair. So I will write here one pair. Okay. So suppose this is gear number one and this is gear number two. So these two gears are in mesh. Now one tooth on gear number one and one tooth on gear number two are in mesh. So what will be the contact ratio? A pair, one tooth from this side and one tooth from this side, that we are going to call it as a pair. And what is the contact ratio? Then we are going to say that contact ratio of one. Okay. Write down definition. Contact ratio or number of pairs of teeth. So what is alternative word for contact ratio? That is number of pairs of teeth. Already I have shown. So number of pairs of, okay, number of pairs of teeth in contact is defined as ratio of length of arc of contact, ratio of length of arc of contact to the circular pitch. To the circular pitch. To the circular pitch. To the circular pitch. Now, whatever figure I am drawing on this slide, check this. This is circular pitch. And in this, what we have seen? This length of arc of approach and length of arc of recess. These are on the pitch circle. Okay. So, this part is from arc of approach. So, check down definition. Contact ratio or number of pairs of teeth in contact is defined as ratio of length of arc of contact. Right. So, this part is arc of approach and this is from other side, or I will use different pen, different colors. 1 minute. Very important definition. Okay. Now, if we are going to remove this, this is arc of approach and this is arc of recess. Okay. So, combinedly, it is length of arc of contact. And what is this part? This segment, we are going to call it as a circular pitch. So, this length of arc of contact divided by circular pitch, that will give the contact ratio. Next line you can write, contact ratio is equal to, length of arc of contact, length of arc of contact in bracket GPF, in short whatever figure on the previous slide. So there we have used this GPF divided by circular pitch. So this is also important relation. Write down where PC is equal to pi m. PC is equal to pi m. And we know how to calculate this m. M is nothing but module and is equal to d by t. So, as there is no numerical treatment, just you need to remember these formulas and the terminology. Next, you can write a very important bit with respect to your campus interview. As a mechanical engineer, you should know the significance of the contact ratio. Okay. So, when we are concluding that gear are having contact ratio of 1. That indicates one tooth from this side and one tooth from wheel side are in contact. Number of pairs of teeth in contact, jodi, right? So one means contact ratio as a one. So for a gear combination, the contact ratio should be more than one. Okay. So first you can write, usually the contact ratio is not a whole number. Not a whole number. Not a whole number. Now, one pair is in contact, and as the contact between these two, as the contact between these two disengages or terminates, other pair of teeth will be in contact. So, what indicates? This is one, and other pair is having some contact, maybe 0.20% contact, maybe 0.40% contact, maybe 0.60% contact. So take example, you can write, for instance, write down, it is very very important. For instance, if the contact ratio is 1.6, is 1.6, is 1.6, comma, it does not mean that, it does not mean that, mean that there are 1.6 pairs of teeth in contact. 1.6 pairs of teeth in contact. म्हणजे एक पेयर पूर्ण आणि दुसरा 60% असं होत नाही, राईट? सो जस्ट यू कॅन कंटिन्यू, इट मीन्स दॅट देर आर अल्टरनेटिवली वन पेयर, अँड टू पेयर्स ऑफ टीथ इन कॉन्टॅक्ट, in contact, and on the time basis the average is 1.6, the average is 1.6, 1.6. That means first pair is having 100% contact and second pair is having 0.60 contact or 60% contact. Again, whatever 60, the pairs having 60% contact, it will become 1. Again, next tooth pair will have 0.60% 60% contact. Right? 100% contact असणारा एका पेयर, त्याच वेळेस दुसरा जो पेयर आहे त्याच्यामध्ये 60% कॉन्टॅक्ट असणार, परत पहिल्या पेयर कॉन्टॅक्ट संपणार, जो 60 आहे तो 100 होणार आणि नवीन पेयर येणार आहे त्याच्यामध्ये 60% असणार आहे. लक्षात आलं का? So alternatively, that means one for first, 100% for first pair. At that time, for second pair, 60%. Again, for first pair, it terminates. Whatever 60% for the second pair, it becomes 100%, and again next pair will have 60%. That means a gear ratio of 1.6%. It means that on the basis of time basis, it is 100% for first pair and 60% for second pair, and it is going to be changed alternatively. Okay. Next, you can write the theoretical minimum value for the contact ratio is 1. Contact ratio is 1. That is, there must always be at least one pair of teeth in contact for continuous action. एक पेयर तर कॉन्टॅक्ट मध्ये लागतोय टू हॅव कंटिन्युअस ट्रान्समिशन ऑफ द पॉवर, अँड रिमेनिंग पेयर इज हॅव्हिंग 60%, 40% आउट ऑफ 100% कॉन्टॅक्ट. राईट. ओके. नेक्स्ट लाईन यू कॅन राईट, दिस इज इम्पॉर्टंट. लार्जर द कॉन्टॅक्ट रेशो, larger the contact ratio, more quietly the gears will operate. So it should be more than one. Asa honar nahi ki ha gear varche 3 tooth ani dusrya gear varche 3 tooths they are going to have some मेशिंग. एकाच वेळेस तीन तीन पेयर मेश मध्ये असणार नाही. सो लॉजिकली यू शुड थिंक ऑर वी कॅन चेक दिस. सो आय विल शो ओके. नाउ चेक हियर, दिस इज one pair is in contact and remaining pair, this is first pair and this one is second pair. आता ह्याच्यामध्ये 100% कॉन्टॅक्ट नाही, 80-90% आहे. इथं जस्ट इट हॅज बीन स्टार्टेड. दॅट मीन्स मोर दॅन वन पेअर ऑफ टीथ should be in contact in order to transmit continuous power. Check karayta ha pair madhe contact hoto release hota na, ya dogan madhe parat continuous hote. Check kar. So what is contact ratio? Number of pairs of teeth in contact, one pair and some part from the second pair, one pair and some part from the second pair, continuously it is going to be changed, right? So it should be more than one. So this is the significance with respect to the contact ratio. This we have seen. Next, you can write next bit.
Sir. Hello? Sir, the fourth significance काय होतं?
Fourth दाखवतो एकच मिनिट. हा, larger the contact ratio, more quietly the gears will operate. सांगू का परत एकदा हे समजून. ओके
नको सर.
हाँ, लार्जर द कॉन्टॅक्ट रेशियो म्हणजे एक पेयर आहे आणि त्याच्यामधला कॉन्टॅक्ट संपत असताना दुसऱ्या पेयर मध्ये जर कॉन्टॅक्ट राहिला तर पॉवर ट्रान्समिशनची ऍक्शन आहे, इट विल बी स्मूथ. हॅलो हॅलो, 1 मिनिट. हां ओके. एक पेयर कॉन्टॅक्ट मध्ये आहे आणि त्याच्यामधला कॉन्टॅक्ट संपत असताना दुसऱ्या पेयर मध्ये जर एंगेजमेंट झाली, मीन्स इफ कॉन्टॅक्ट रेशियो इज 1.1, एक पेयर आणि दुसऱ्या पेयर मध्ये 0.1 कॉन्टॅक्ट असणार आहे, त्याच्याऐवजी 1.5 जर असेल तर एक पेयर 100% आणि दुसरा पेयर 50%. म्हणजे पहिल्याचं संपत नाही तोपर्यंत दुसऱ्यामध्ये जर 50 होत असेल, दॅट विल गिव मोअर क्वाईट ऑपरेशन. ओके, नेक्स्ट यू कॅन राईट इंटरफरन्स इन इन्व्हॉल्व्ड गिअर्स. इंटरफरन्स इन इन्व्हॉल्व्ड गिअर्स, इंटरफरन्स इन इन्व्हॉल्व्ड गिअर्स. नेक्स्ट लाईन यू कॅन राईट इंटरफरन्स, इंटरफरन्स, इंटरफरन्स सो राईट डाऊन द फेनॉमिनन, द फेनॉमिनन, द फेनॉमिनन when the tip of tooth, tip of tooth, tip of tooth, tip of tooth undercut, undercut the root, root on its mating gear, root on its mating gear, mating gear, mating gear, mating gear is known as interference, is known as interference. So for that I will show this is tip, okay. So this is tooth form wheel, so I will just write here W and here I will write P. It indicates that this is the tooth on the pinion. Okay, this way it is going to rotate and this way it is going to rotate, right? So when this will rotate in the clockwise direction, this tip of tooth on the pinion, this is the tip, it will undercut. So here it is mentioned, undercut root on its mating gear. Ha pahila gear, ha dusra gear, ha pinion, he will, right? Ha tooth sir रूटचा थोडासा पार्ट इट इज इट विल गेटिंग रिमूव्ह ड्यू टू दिस टिप अँड दॅट फेनॉमेना इज कॉल्ड एज अ इंटरफरन्स. दैट फेनोमेना इज कॉल्ड एज इंटरफेरेंस. ओके, राइट डाउन. दिस इफेक्ट इज नोन एज इंटरफेरेंस. दिस इफेक्ट इज नोन एज इंटरफेरेंस. दिस इफेक्ट इज नोन एज इंटरफेरेंस. This will be asked. Why I have indicated here? Why I have marked here tick marked these two these words? So this may be asked for MCQ. This may be asked for MCQ. Okay. Next. So just I will show once again. This is the tooth on the wheel, and as this part is removed, what will happen? This will weakens the tooth of the wheel. त्याच्यामुळे हा इथला जो टूथ आहे व्हील वरचा, दॅट विल गोइंग टू बी वीकन. ओके, जस्ट चेक आउट दिस ॲनिमेशन्स. ओके, सो दिस साइड इज पिनियन. सो जस्ट आई विल राइट हियर पी एंड हियर इट इज, सॉरी, एज पर द फिगर वॉट एवर वे वी हैव रिटन, जस्ट बेस्ड ऑन दैट दिस वन इज पिनियन एंड दिस इज व्हील. सो विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू दिस फिगर we need to demonstrate. Okay, so this is pinion, this one is the wheel, right? What you are observing here, this area, this is the tip. Okay, and this is root, manje base cha part, right? So it is getting removed by the tip. Okay, this is called as interference. This is called as interference. Okay, samajle ka ha diagram varun, ha animation ani hi figure. Next. So this is about definition and the phenomena. What is interference? This definition you have taken. This sentence you have taken. Next, you can write. Now, here we are going to determine maximum length of path of contact. So take down this diagram and once again you can write, because this is once again a small expression, but it is required. Okay, how to draw? Now here this is base circle, so I will draw for one base circle, then pitch circle, देन एडेंडम सर्कल एंड वन मोर सर्कल, दिस इज मैक्सिमम एडेंडम सर्कल, दिस इज मैक्सिमम एडेंडम सर्कल, दिस इज एंड दिस वन, दिस इज फॉर पिनियन एंड दिस इज फॉर द व्हील. ओके, सो अगेन दिस वन इज द पीस सर्कल. So, to have practice, okay, this is base circle, this is addendum circle, and this one is the maximum addendum circle. Here it is, pitch point. Okay. So like this, you can draw this diagram. Draw the diagram. Completed.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then, whatever interference that we have seen. So, when the tip of tooth undercut the root on its mating gear is known as interference. Now, let us see the diagram carefully. So, this one is maximum addendum circle. So, here for I will write here maximum, and for this also I will write here maximum. Right. Now this is, if you are going to consider O1L, what is this? This is nothing but addendum circle radius. Ita baga addendum circle, and this O1L, this is addendum circle radius. इथे जर आपण असा टूथ काढला राईट, सो दिस इज अडेंडम सर्कल. ओके, सपोज दिस इज द बेस्ट सर्कल. कशाचं बेस्ट सर्कल आहे? व्हीलचं. दिस वन इज बेस्ट सर्कल ऑफ द व्हील. Okay, now if we are going to increase this O1L beyond this L, so at O1L, so here I will write L, and somewhere here O1. Okay, if we are going to increase addendum circle radius, this is O1L1, again increase O1L2, and up to this, so this is maximum addendum circle. आता ह्या यांच्या बियॉन्ड जर गेलो आपण, व्हॉट विल हॅपन? सो दिस इज द बेस्ट सर्कल, हिअर इट इज एन पॉइंट, आणि ह्या यांच्या आतमध्ये जर गेलो, दॅट मीन्स if the radius of addendum circle of the pinion increases beyond this O1L, here it is O1N, yachyanantar pudha jar apan increase keli tar kay honar aahe? Base circle cha aat, mhanje ithe root of the wheel. So beyond this n we cannot increase the addendum circle radius of the pinion. So I'm stopping here. So tomorrow we'll see this simple bit. Okay.